As now we are going to write the sixth question. Up to five questions completed. So 6, 7, 8 is there. So we are going to see the sixth question. What did the tiger do? Find out if his friend had betrayed him. So sixth answer is also completed. Yes, sir. To find out his friend betrayed him, the tiger, when it was time for man to visit the tiger. So sixth answer also completed. Now I am writing the seventh one. So seventh question you write, children. Seventh answer I am writing. Okay. So go home, my friend. I will never come to meet you in your home. I will stay in the forest and promise to never harm you unless man provokes me. Who is the speaker and who is his friend? Who is the speaker there? So the tiger is the speaker and man is his friend. So write down. The tiger is the speaker. The tiger is the speaker and the man is his friend. So this means what? Who is his ear? Tiger only. So tiger. Okay. So next, B bit. So what is the B bit? Why did the speaker never visit friend again? The speaker would never visit his friend again because the last time. So write up, the speaker would never visit his friend again. Because the last time he visited his friend, he was followed, by his friends. So next, C bit answer. So do you think man provokes the tiger? How? Yes, man provokes the tiger by entering his home and attacking him. So right on. Yes. Man provokes the tiger. By entering his home and attacking him. Okay, next, eighth one. The man had women as well as the tiger as his friends. Who was the true friend, the man? Why do you think so? They worked together, they supported each other, they fought with each other, they kept their promises. So what is the correct answer? The tiger was a true friend to the man because they supported each other. So write up. The tiger. The tiger was the true friend to the man. The tiger was a true friend to the man because they supported each other. Okay, children. So this is the three questions. So complete the answers. Okay, children. Welcome to the class. So So that lesson is completed, question and answer. Next fourth lesson, friends. Okay, friends lesson lo question and answers we are going to see. So let us write the appropriate stanza numbers against the summary of each stanza given below and has been done for you summary here stanza. So a child should never be scared since she has many gentle friends near her. So this is stanza 4. Yes, this is stanza 4. A child should never be scared since she has many gentle friends near her. This is stanza 4. She feels the sunshine which comes in and out through the leaves. It kisses her face like her mother does before she goes to bed. So ekkada undi nanadi this 1 2 6 stanza 2. So to write the stanza 2. So next, that poet likes to lie down on the grass and look through the trees. Yes, she feels that sky bends on her sweetly like a kind big smile. So kind big smile, this is stanza 1. Okay, though the poet can't see the wind, she can feel it pausing and whispering pretty things on the grass. So where it is, yes, this is stanza 3. Okay, so already I sent this also, go through the back side. Next, answer these questions. How good to lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sky is like a kind big smile, bent sweetly over me. Who is the speaker? What is she doing? How does she feel to lie a little? How does the sky seem to her? So now we are going to see that. Yes, below first one, I am writing the answer. You just write the question. Okay. Sorry. How good to lie? Lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sky is like a kind big smile, bent sweetly. Who is the speaker? What is she doing? The speaker is lying under a tree on the grass. She is looking up through the tree. So right, the speaker is lying under a tree. First answer. Speaker means what? Poem has no speaker. The speaker is lying. The speaker is lying under a tree. Under a tree on the grass. Under a tree on the grass. She is looking up through the tree. She is looking up through the tree. So this is the first one answer. First one low, even. Okay, the speaker is lying under the tree on the grass. She is looking up through the tree. So second one. So what is the second one? How does she feel to lie a little? She feels good to lie a little. So second one. She feels good to lie a little. She feels good to lie a little. Okay, next sea bit. Next, how does the sky seem to her? Yes, the sky seems like a kind big smile bent sweetly over her. The sky seems like a The sky seems like a kind big tree. Kind big smile. Kind big smile. Bent sweetly over. Bent sweetly over there. Okay, so next, first bit is easy. Next, second bit. Why does the poet feel the sunshine? Like, is like her mother. Second answer now. This first answer, A, B, C. So, second answer, why does the poet feel that the is like sunshine like mother? The poet feels that sunshine is like mother because it kisses up her face like her mother does before going to bed. So, right now, because किसेस अपॉन हर फेस, किसेस अपॉन हर फेस लाइक हर मदर. Like her mother does before going to bed. Next, Tama. So, how does the wind make its presence felt? So, right, stealing over the grass. Stealing over the grass. Stealing over the grass and whispering pretty things. And whispering pretty things. Stealing over the grass and whispering pretty things. Though the poet cannot see him pass. Okay, so next. So many gentle friends are here who one can scarcely see. A child should never feel fear wherever he may be. Who are the gentle friends? So fourth one here. The gentle friends are the different elements of nature. So fourth one here. The gentle. The gentle friends are different elements of nature. The gentle friends are different elements of nature. So what are the sky, the sunshine and the wind. The sky, the sunshine and the wind. Okay, next fourth law, BB. Why are the gentle friends scarcely seen? Because he has so many, because he has so many gentle friends near him. Because he has so many gentle friends near him. Next, CB. Why should a child never feel a fear? A child should never feel a fear because he has so many gentle friends near. So, hey children, so this one is the right ones. So, BBIT law, just write BBIT. Because their presence can only fail. Because their presence. Because their presence. Because their presence can only fail. Next. Because he has so many gentle friends near him. Because he has so many gentle friends here. So hope you understood the writing. Okay, So fifth one. What does the poem convey? What does the poem convey? The poem conveys that one doesn't need to worry. So fifth answer. I'm shortcut it and write. Okay, one doesn't need to worry. One doesn't need to worry or fear because one can always find friend. Find friend in the form of fear, in the form of nature, in the form of nature and its various elements, and its various various elements. Gentleness and the boundary and the bounty of nature can be built by your of nature can be built. Can be felt by everyone. So these are the question and answer, children. So go through it again and again and again. So pass it on the video. Choose from the sloga. You complete it. Okay. So the two lessons, question and answers, will be completed. Now your task has to read and practice the question and answers. Okay. That is the syllabus. The third lesson and fourth lesson. Third lesson is when you do tiger setup. Fourth lesson is breathing. Okay. Right. Bye.